Yes, sir.
Okay, so yesterday we stopped here in transformation process. So I'll start from here. So what has happened is that, okay, let me take here.
In Joseph's Academy,
okay, so basically, the thing is that if we want to run the translation process, we had to define this reporting currency in order to report in the different representation. But we did not create this part. I mean, we left this one. We said that we will see it at translation process. And I thought it is created already. So that's the issue. So now we have created with the name Metro Express, and we gave the conversion level as balance because we wanted to see the balance of the particular currency for the given account. And the rate we have selected as corporate. Okay. And what we are trying to translate here is that revenue and expenses, that is our P&L accounts along with our ownership equity accounts. Okay. So we saw that balance sheet accounts are being revalued there. So here in translation, we can see that it is for P&L accounts. Okay. So we have created this reporting currency. So now we will go back to the translation and we will run the process. Okay, so this is our data access set and this is our ledger, and target currency automatically it has picked up because we defined only one reporting currency. We did not give more than one. So if we have given more than one, probably it will be blank and we will have to select it from the list. Since it is only one currency, so it has picked automatically. And let me pick this for April 21 period. And let's say I have probably 20 or 50 balancing segments, and I wanted to run this for a specific balancing segment. So I can choose this. But in our case, we have only two balancing segments, and that too, the transaction that we have is only for 01, that is Metro Express. Okay. So I'm just leaving this as open. So the balances are translated. Okay, and this is for the period April 21. Okay. Any doubt till now?
Actually, this translation is to just see conversion of rates.
So the difference between the conversion and translation is that in conversion, what will happen is that, let's say I'm doing this transaction on 10th of April. So immediately on the 10th of April, this will be converted from our base currency to the entered currency. That is, if I'm doing a transaction from INR to USD, so my functional currency is INR, my foreign currency is USD. So in this case, when I do transaction, if you see our journal entries, so the moment we save this particular record, automatically the accounted currency balances will be updated. So that we call as an conversion. The translation is a process wherein we will translate the balances not on the date when we made the transaction, but instead we will run on the month end. So on the month end, we will check whether there are any discrepancies or anything that has to be reported. So that will be taken as a translated balance. So that is the difference between the conversion and the translation. And this translation is only for P&L accounts.
Okay, sir.
So we'll go to next topic. So next one is on the budget. Okay. Okay, so firstly, I'll enable this budgetary controls at ledger. So that is when I'll be able to start with my basic configuration. So I'll enable it for my ledger. So that is my ledger is Metro. So I'll pick this. So here we can see that this is my ledger. So I haven't enabled budgetary control or encumbrance for this particular ledger. So what we will do is that we will pick this one and we will enable the budgetary control. Okay, so I'll say enable budgetary control for ledger and all journal sources and categories. Okay, so here we have certain controls and in order to use the budget. So whether I want this particular budgetary control, which I'm enabling at my ledger, is only for the ledger or it is only for the project or it can be used by project and ledger. So when we say ledger, which means our general ledger and our sub ledger like APAR and the other things also. Usually we will not have the budget and the other things affect our revenue, that is accounts receivable. So those things we will take it as part of forecasting. So that is different. So here what we will see is that we, here it is this thing, what we call for expenses, that is accounts payable. Okay, so I'll pick only ledger. And then we have the few controls over here as well, whether the transaction date fails outside the range. So how system should control it. So whether system should fail it or how it should handle it. So this is not a mandatory setup. So I'm just leaving this as it is. Okay, and then we have few exceptions. So whether I wanted any categories or the sources to be excluded from this budgetary control or the budget option. So I can enable that here. So here in this case, I will not need budget controls in revaluation. So we saw revaluation is nothing but revaluing our currency at end of the month or any certain period. So here in this case, I don't need this budget to be enabled for this revaluation, because that is just a process wherein it revalues the currency rate at the current state. So I don't need this option for revaluation. And the second and third is that open balances. So open balance is nothing but we have trial balance wherein we will have the opening balance and the closing balance. So I don't want to have the budgetary controls for open balance and the closing balance also. So I'm excluding. So similarly, if I have a requirement that I don't want to handle this at receivable, so I'll add the source as receivable, so that this budgetary control will not be enabled at receivable end. So similarly, I can add any number of exceptions which can be excluded. Okay. And then we have the budgetary control to be enabled at the business unit. So whether I wanted to enable this at business unit also, so I can enable it here. Okay. So now if I enable this at the budgetary control at business unit, I have certain other features also. So whether I wanted to have this for requisition, procurement, expense management for everything, or I wanted to have for only for the expense management. So expense management or let's say our payable invoicing. So whether if I want to have only for this, I can say yes, and here I can say no. Or probably if I want to have the budgetary control to be enabled for the entire sequence, so I can enable it here. Or let's say I wanted to give certain transaction types, I can filter it out here. Okay, so I can say no here. So similarly, we have the expense management also. Okay. Similarly, here as well, like if I want to give control that to enable for a certain transaction type, I can enable it here. Okay, and then we have an option to enable general category source and this thing to be enabled for all the categories. So I can enable it here. So this is perspective to project accounting, not our APR this module. So this is project accounting perspective. So I'm just leaving it as it is. And then we have a few exceptions that can be added. Like we have the budgetary controls exceptions. So wherein if I have any certain transaction source that has to be taken out of this preview. So I can add it there. I can add it here. So let me just show this. I'm not adding it. Okay. So I'm just selecting the Fusion projects So in projects, basically we have multiple parts to it. That is, we have a time card, we have allocation, burden, resource allocation. So there are a lot of tasks. So if I want to give this budgetary control for any particular task or exclude any particular task, I can exclude it here. Okay. So at this point, I'm not giving anything here. I'll just remove this. Okay, so we have enabled budget for our ledger. Okay, so then we have something called encumbrance. So encumbrance, when we will use is that when we, let's say we are implementing for a client who is doing manufacturing business. So here we need to understand the basic difference between budget and our encumbrance. So budget is something that is a planned activity. So if I know this month I need 10,000 as an expense, I can keep it aside and I can do my spending on the given month. So this we call as a budget. This is a planned activity. But encumbrance on the other side is an unplanned activity where this will work for kind of a manufacturing industry wherein we cannot predict the raw material need and the other things. So even though we have the forecasting and the other things to know what exactly the count we might need, but we will not, we cannot make sure that this is the exact count that we will be needing. So that is why we call this as an unplanned activity. So this will fall under encumbrance accounting. So this will take you through our requisition, purchase order, and from there it will come to the invoicing. So this part we call it as an encumbrance. Okay. So now we are not enabling encumbrance. For now, we will see budgets. Okay. Okay, so we have given this at ledger. So the next step is to create the budget calendar. Okay, so here I'm just giving name as a metro budget and then the period frequency. So how frequent we wanted to say that this is a next period. So I will say this is a monthly budget. So I'll select monthly. Okay, and I don't need to create all these things because this is normal calendar. I don't want this as a normal calendar. So I'll enable this option called budgetary control only. Okay, so now this will change accordingly. So based on this period, basically the budget calendar will be created. So I'll say this is an 12 months budget. That is for a year I'm planning for a budget. Okay, so here we can see this is our budget calendar. So basically we will have the start date, so we will have to just give the end date. Okay, so we are done with our calendar. So basically we defined this as a budgetary calendar, and we just gave dates. Okay, so now if I want to open it for next year, I'll just add a budget year. So it's a similar process. The year will be added, so we will just give have to give the dates. That's it. Okay, so we are done with the calendar. And the next part is to create the control budget. Okay, so this is our budget. So I'm just selecting from the start period to our end period, that is Jan to December. Okay, so here we have different things, that is control budget, and then we have EPM financials, then we have Hyperion planning and the other things. So control budget is something that whether if I want to have what you call the consolidated budget. So let's say I have a budget for 10 different items of the companies. So here, whether I wanted to consolidate and say this as an one single budget to track it in a better way. So I can say that also in control budget. And another thing that we have is that EPM. So EPM is a different module by itself. So we will have to configure there, and that budget, whatever we are giving it there. So that should be linked up here, okay? So that is what we call as an EPM financial module. And then we have Hyperion planning. So Hyperion is a different platform which was procured by Oracle, okay? So that is again a different module. So we will have to configure there and we will have to attach it here. So no budget is something that we are not using this for budget. So that's the understanding. So I'll just say other. Okay, so other is normal budget, which we are doing. Okay. And our currency is MUR. I'm just selecting MUR. Okay. And default rate, I'm choosing as in corporate because even in revaluation translation, we use the corporate rate. So I'm just picking the same thing. Okay. And then here, if you see, we have a few controls in terms of managing our budget. So whether I wanted to have this as an absolute or I wanted to have this as an advisory or track it. So the difference between absolute and advisory is that if I enable this as an absolute, let's say there is a fund that has to be there, like minimum is 1 lakh. So if at all I don't have the fund with me, so the system will not allow me to complete this transaction. It will give me an error stating that fund check has been failed. But whereas if I select advisory, it is going to give me warning stating that the fund is low, but it is not going to restrict me in order to posting this particular journal entry or completing any transaction. Okay, so which means advisory is just going to give me warning message, but still I'll be able to complete the transaction. But whereas in case of absolute, what will happen is that I can basically restrict this particular transaction, but not allowing it. Okay, and the third option that we have is track. So track is something that it is kind of a reporting purpose where it will not even give what you call the warning or anything. it will just allow. But if we want to take the report out of it, we can run a report and we can take this, like how many times this fun check has failed and how many times it has passed. All those things we will be able to track it. But the thing is that it will not give us warning or it will not restrict us. Okay. So I'll just say this as an obsolete. Okay. And then we have the tolerance percentage and amount. So tolerance percentage is something that, let's say the fund requirement is 1 lakh. So now the fund which I have is 1 lakh, but the bill that I'm trying to make is that 1 lakh 10,000. So this is above the limit. And the control which we have taken up is absolute. So in absolute, it is not going to allow me to complete the transaction. So I need to add another 10,000. But this is an immediate payment. So this addition will go through a multiple process. Let's say it will take 1 day. But this payment has to be released today UAD. So what I can do is that probably I can give an exceptional case wherein the tolerance percentage would be 10%. So if I say 10%, in this case, I'll be able to approve this bill if it is 1,10,000. If it is above 1,10,000, system is not going to allow it. So that is the thing that we have it in tolerance. So tolerance can be either in percentage or it can be in amount. Okay, so I'm selecting the ledger. Okay, I'm just selecting the user here. Okay. And then we have an option to have it controlled at funds addition and these things. So wherein whether I wanted system to allow increase the budget or decrease the budget. So definitely we might need this option because it is not that we will just say that it is 1 lakh and we will use it for the entire year. So there might be a slightly change here and there. So accordingly we can adjust it. Okay, so I'm just enabling both the options, that is increase adjustment and the decrease adjustment. Okay, and then we have allow budget decrease adjustment below funds available. So if the fund is below the limit, so whether I want to allow the adjustments, so that is also possible if we enable this option. I'm not selecting this as of now. And then allow override. So allow override is something that apart from the controls that we have placed in, whether I want to override. So that is what it is. So I'm just unselecting this as well. Okay. And then we have the budget segments. So for which segment we wanted to have this budget controls. So I'll say account. Okay. So now I have given this for the entire account segments. It is not particular to any particular account range, but instead it is for the all the accounts. Okay. So what I can do is that if at all I have a requirement to, let's say, give a restriction only to a specific accounts, let's say from account range 1001 to 1025. So what I can do is that I can create a supplemental rule. So why are the reason behind this supplemental rule is that basically it will allow us to override the controls that we gave in header. So this we can say as line level information, and the earlier configuration we saw is our header level configuration. So here I can give this, let's say I'll give this, I'm not creating supplemental rule, I'm just explaining it. So let me say, okay. So I can enable it for a particular business unit. This is not mandatory. So if at all I have a requirement, that only this particular business unit will have this control, I can enable it at business unit also. Okay, and then similar option. So whatever the option that we are selecting it here for this particular business unit or for this particular account range, so this will override the header level configuration which we gave earlier. So because let's say the configuration that we gave at earlier configuration is absolute. So now I don't want to use absolute. I want to use the advisory. So I can give advisory here and I can select specific business unit and I can say account range is 1021 to 25, which means only for this 5 accounts, it will consider as an advisory. Rest of the accounts will be used as absolute. Okay. So that's about this one. Okay. And then we have the account values. So whether we want to use the all accounts or we, what exactly we want to use. So that's about it. Okay. So if I want to use specific account, I can give my range here. Okay, I think this is some form level issue. Okay, we did not save that, so I'm just creating once again. Okay, so that's the thing. So we saw till here. So that is if I want to give a range of accounts, I can add that particular range. Okay. And so that's what. So if I have a requirement to add it for different business unit, so we will have to create multiple supplemental rules. Okay. And then we have few transaction filters as well. So we can say any specific business function to be used. So similar to our earlier configuration, like let's say journal category are the source. We have payables, we have receivables. So I want to include this only for payables. I can include this. Okay. So that's about the supplemental rule. Okay. So I'm just saving this. So here we can see status as not ready for use, which means this is under definition. So we are not at created this particular budget. So in order to create this budget, what I will have to do is that, so we can see that still it is not ready for use. I'll click the action. So I'll say prepare for use. Okay, so the report has triggered. So now we should get this cubes also created for this particular budget. So we'll check in the schedule process. Okay, so let's wait for the cubes to be created. So probably after that, we'll be able to see the status as active. So once this is activated, then we can check the budgetary controls in our journal entry. Okay, so our schedule process is done. So now what we will do is that we will check whether the budgetary control which we are creating is active. Okay, before that, I'll give the required roles to the user. So that is this user, Metro Express. So I'll navigate to security console. Okay, so there are three roles that we'll give to this particular user. So that is budget preparer, budget analyst, and budget manager. Yeah, we are done with adding roles. We have given the roles. So we will just log out and log in once. Let me check once. We should have got the budget roles, but okay, this should come in the budgetary options. But somehow we are not seeing it. I'm not sure whether they have update in 20D. So this is the latest version. Okay, let me check this one and we'll see tomorrow.
Okay, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, thanks.
Thank you.